Hi. Welcome to my channel, Be Smart Together. You can call me KT. Not Katie. In the previous video, we covered data extraction and load. Today, I will show you data transformation in Power Query. Let's spend a few minutes to recap the navigation of Power Query Editor, before we continue our data transformation. There are four tabs: Home, Transform, Add Column, and View. The first three tabs give you the functionality to transform data, whereas View allows you to switch on or off various views. Queries pane is on the left. You can click to expand it and click it again to hide it. Query settings is on the right. It records all transformation steps, and you can go back and forth with your steps. You can change the query name as well. To change the query name, you need to go to the top right corner, Properties, and Name. Then, select the existing query name to override it. Now, let's scroll the preview screen to the right. The last two columns, Client and Postcode, these columns are 100% empty and have no values. How do I know? Column quality tells me. It is right below the column header. It says 100% empty. If you don't have the column quality, go to the View tab and tick the column quality box. So, we want to delete these two columns. Select the client column, hold the control key, and select the postcode column. Go to Home, Remove Column, and you have two options: remove columns and remove other columns. Oops. I have accidentally selected remove other columns. It removed all other columns. What shall I do? Don't worry. Hover your mouse over to the Remove Other Columns step in Query Settings. This step recorded what we did. Click on the cross, and it will remove the step. Now we have undone our mistake. So let's reselect those two columns, then go to Remove Columns, Remove Columns. Or, you can go to those selected columns header, then right click and choose Remove Columns. Now, you have learned various ways to delete columns and undo steps. The next function I will show you is Split Column. Let's select the model column, and we want to split the column into two by the delimiter, hyphen. To split the column, go to Home, Split Column, and then select By Delimiter. Before you click it, hold it for a few seconds, and the By Delimiter definition will appear. From the pop-up window, click on the drop-down list, and there are various types of delimiters. Choose Custom if none of those is correct. Usually, Power Query will detect your delimiter. Click Custom, and you will see the hyphen is already there. Click OK to continue. Now you see the column split into two. The two split columns are named with model dots 1 and 2. Let's change it to proper column names. I want you to double-click on the column header, model.1, and then rename it to brand. Let's do the same to the model.2 column. Rename it to model. We have sales price and quantity in this data model, but we do not have the total sales amount at the transaction level. And, we would generally add a column with formula, price multiply quantity. Let's select columns price from and quantity, and I will show you a super smart way to do the multiplication in Power Query. Go to the Add Column tab after selecting those two columns, then click Standard. The one has a plus minus multiply division icon. You will see various calculation methods, and we need to choose multiply in this case. Here you go. The sales amount is ready, but I don't like the column name. So let's change the column name in another way. Right-click on the column header, then select Rename. Rename it to sales space dollar sign. The data look pretty much okay now. No. I don't like the hyphen in the financial year column. I want to replace hyphen with forward slash. Let's select the financial year column. Go to Home, then click on Replace Value. From the pop-up, enter hyphen for value to find and forward slash for replace with. Then, click OK to continue. Now we have successfully replaced hyphen with forward slash. Let's load our query in Excel. Hover your mouse over to the top left corner, click Close and Load, then Close and Load 2. Select Pivot Table Report from the pop-up, then click OK to continue. Let's quickly build a summary by pivot table. Select brand for rows, quantity and sales for value. Let's do some magic to tidy up the number format. Now we have loaded the data in Excel, but we need to go back to edit the data. So, how to do that? Let's go to Queries and Connection, right-click on the query, then select Edit. Now we are back to Power Query Editor. Since we are back to Power Query Editor, perhaps let me show you how to group data. Oh my goodness. What is group data? Group data means you can group or summarize your data from many rows and columns to fewer rows and columns. Go to the Home tab and select Group By. Click the period and select brand from the drop-down list from the pop-up window. Change the new column name from count to quantity, then choose sum from the operation drop-down list. Choose quantity for column. If you have more columns to group or more measures, you need to switch from basic to advanced. Once you switch over, you will get add grouping and add aggregation. Click on the add aggregation and get a new input row. Enter sales for the new column name, change count row to sum under operation, and change period to sales for the measure column. Click on the add grouping and get a new input row. You will get period as a default, and let's leave it as it is. Click OK once you are happy with your selection. I am not quite happy with the grouping. Let's change it. Go to the query settings, click on the little gear icon at the grouped rows step to change the grouping. I want to delete the quantity measure. First, click the three dots, then choose delete from the pop-up. Now click OK to continue. Now it is time to show you my two favorite functions in Power Query, pivot and unpivot columns. Select the period column, go to the transform tab and click the pivot column. From the pop-up, choose sales to replace brand for the value column, then click OK. Magic is about to happen. Let's do it the other way around now. Go to the transform tab, and click on unpivot columns. You have three options here. So, select unpivot other columns, which will unpivot all other columns except selected columns. Another critical thing for Power Query is data type. If the data type is defined as text for a number column, it will become a text column. In this example, the attribute column is defined as text instead of date. Select the attribute column, go to the Home tab, and click on data type to redefine the data type. Or, you can click on the ACB icon in the attribute column, then select date to define the column as a date column. The last helpful tip today is delete steps. Let's go to the query settings, then select the grouped rows step, and it will take you back to the previous steps. We want to keep grouped rows as our last step, so right-click at the next step, pivoted column, and select delete until end. Choose delete and delete everything after the grouped rows step. You just learned the quickest way to delete multiple steps. Let's click close and load to load the transformed data into Excel. We have covered some essential functions today, which will help you with most data transformations. I will continue to cover various data transformation functions in future videos. Thank you for watching. Please click subscribe and turn on the notification to avoid missing useful videos. Click like if you like the video, or feel free to drop a comment for anything Excel challenge you have, and you like to know what is the best way to deal with it. I will try to create some example videos in future.